The state legislature is also scheduled to act on a proposal to rename a part of I-43. As 12 News' Mike Anderson reports, new at 6, it's in honor of a local civic leader who championed the cause of the disadvantaged.
Community to have victory over violence. The people have got to begin to believe there has victory. There must be symbols.
Milwaukee community activist Janetta Robinson believed in symbols, but she also believed in action behind those symbols. She passed away in late 2008, leaving behind a legacy of good deeds, a champion for the poor, children, and peaceful nonviolent resolutions to conflicts. Much of her work was in the central city, not far from the I-43 freeway. Tomorrow, the Wisconsin legislature is expected to consider renaming part of the freeway in her honor.
And the question that usually comes up when things are going is, who's going to pay for this? What we have done, CYD, and we've been out and asking people for their help to pay for the signage, we've already raised over $7,500 within the last 2 weeks.
The signs would go up between North Avenue and Keefe Avenue. That's the section that would be renamed. Janetta's son, Charles Butch Walton, took over Janetta's career youth development organization after she died. He has drawn up a suggestion of what he thinks it should look like. It's big, and in the neighborhood, Janetta's proteges say it should be.
Janetta Robinson was here, and she had a cause that need to keep going, you know what I'm saying? So I think that it will be a beautiful thing to come through, and then it also helped most people look up and wonder, who was that person?
There's not expected to be much opposition, if any at all, to the proposed Janetta Robinson Highway. The sign may not be as big as her son would like it to be, but he says it will be big enough to make a statement about the woman who dedicated her life to her community. In Milwaukee, Mike Anderson, WISN 12 News.